Gstbody's YouTube channel. I'm Anna Rahe. Gstbody is a holistic body care system that focuses exclusively on fascia and your body's connective tissue system as the solution to body problems like pain, performance, longevity, and other issues that prevent health and vitality. GST looks a little bit like fitness because we move, but it is so much more. GST uses motion to manipulate and remodel fascia to optimize the body's function and health. You get all of the benefits of other therapies like chiropractic, massage, acupuncture, Reiki, with the movements and techniques that I'm going to teach you. Enjoy the wide variety of videos that you'll find here to match all your body's needs, like this one coming up next. Hi, this is a video that's kind of part of a series that we've been doing on the vagus nerve. And today we're gonna talk about breath and the impact on the vagus nerve, but not usually what you think. A lot of times breath is used as a physiological manipulator, meaning how do you let the nervous system respond to breath in a way that would help to activate and direct the vagus nerve to create a parasympathetic response in the body. That is good. And that can be done very simply through long and sustained breathing in through the nose and funneling it down and through. As you inhale through your nose, you let your diaphragm drop. This helps to release tensions on that nerve and starts to allow the brain to get oxygen and cycles this information from the base of the skull down into the torso. But that's not kind of what we're talking about today. Today we're going to be talking about, in the 5-minute fascia flow, how you can use breath to restructure the tissues in your torso and affect how the nerve is laying in tension between where it comes out at the base of the spine and into venerating the thoracic cavity down into your diaphragmatic attachments, okay? Breath is one of the only ways to manipulate deep internal structures. And based upon how your rib cage is held, the tightness of your tissues and the rigidity of your ECM, which is called your extracellular matrix. It's like this jello type quality that is in your body. It's a fascial organ, a connective tissue organ that is highly metabolic, and all of your nerves and blood vessels and lymph nodes and glands sit in this gelatinous material and can become structurally rigid and apply unnecessary or unhealthy stress and tension on your nerves. So this is an exercise video to show you how to open up the tissues and structurally move and influence how the nerve of the vagus nerve is traveling and the tension on that vagus nerve. It will help to stimulate a parasympathetic response, but we're really interested that as you're living, you're able to actually have less stress on the nerve to begin with, so that you're not mechanically loading the nerve that will put you into a physical state of stress. So without further ado, we're gonna start with some breath. You're gonna inhale, lift the arms. When your arms go up and the front line expands, the body feels safe. It does not feel like it's contracted into a like protective, primitive kind of a shape. So we really can access that vagus nerve just by lifting your ribs and allowing the spine to arch. And then exhale, release. Good, again, inhale. And release. In through the nose. And out through the mouth, and almost feel that breath start to expand. So the vagus nerve is not just activated by a physiological response to stress, but also by mechanical loading. And this mechanical loading looks like how the muscles contract into a protective mode. And so it brings your rib cage and curls it forward. It tightens your diaphragm. It brings your traps into kind of like, I'm gonna fight or flight. And so our daily posture is constantly holding the nerve in this restricted straitjacket-like material. And the vagus nerve is activated through mechanical loading rather than just physiological loading, which is oh, there is a lion who's gonna come get me, or my boss is mad at me. So within that breath, we're gonna now go into the diaphragmatic action to trigger space down into the thorax and help the internal volume where the nerve is be able to loosen and have access and motility. So you're going to take your fingers in the sternum and in your chest. You're going to pull up on the ribs and guide the tissue towards your throat. At the same time, you're gonna breathe gently in through your nose, almost touching the lip of your, rim of your upper lip. And as you do this, you're going to drop the diaphragm. It's almost like you poke your belly out. We're gonna create this beautiful stretch in the torso to be able to create space. It looks like this. Pull up. I breathe. I drop the diaphragm. And then I bring it out. Now, here's the key. We're not just trying to control the breath, right? The inhale and the exhale. We're actually using the breath to carve different pathways in the tissues. Very similar to the way that a straw can suck up really thick milkshake, your breath can actually pick up tissue and start to migrate that tissue and influence it, almost like a wave moving the seaweed inside. So let's do this again, and now with that in mind, we're gonna do three of these. You're gonna pick up the tissue, smell your upper lip, drop your diaphragm, and I mean drop it, meaning I'm actually pulling it down rather than pulling it up. See this? Bad. Not preferable. And good. Push it down. I'm not pushing it out. I'm pulling that diaphragm down. And it might be a skill you're going to try to learn. So let's do three more. Inhale. And as you breathe, don't just fill. Pick up the tissue that you're pulling on and move it. Move the tissue. And then drop down and move the diaphragm. Stretch, lift, and release. Pull up. And drop the diaphragm. And I'm closing my eyes because I do much better tapping in and having choices in the tissue when I'm not distracted by cameras or by people or by things. I go into and start tinkering with what's on the inside, the structural tissue on the inside to make it move. Let's do one more together. Inhale. And then the diaphragm drops, pulls down, and release. Fabulous. The mouth is an open aperture, and it's very complementary to the diaphragm, which attaches on all sides of the thorax. There is some fascial connection that exists between the shaping of your mouth and the activity in the diaphragm. So by smelling your upper lip, most people have a really hard time even getting their lip up to their nose because there's so much rigidity in their diaphragm. If this is you, try backing up for a second and just allowing your lip, you can use your fingers, allow your lip to push up against your nose and slouch for a minute, okay? And as you slouch, you're gonna try to breathe right into here to let the diaphragm release, okay? This sniff will help this drop and release. And we're looking just for complementary motion so that we can get that diaphragm, which attaches right around the adrenals and needs to have release. Okay, two more times if this is helpful for being able to get smell, get opening up on the upper lip. We go, inhale. Move the breath, move the structure of the breath, and then release. Do that one more time. Smell the upper lip and guide the diaphragm right where that vagus nerve venerates or matches up with the diaphragm, diving deep into the thoracic cavity, and release. Okay, so one other thing we're gonna try to do is a breath that actually releases the nerve around the cervical spine. The cervical spine throws the head forward when we're stressed, when we think we have to protect ourselves, and by triggering this back line, by allowing the cervical vertebra to stack, not this, but being able to allow that outlet of the spine to feed to the cervical spine, we can actually help to feed the pathway of the vagus nerve and make it function more optimally. take your two fingers right where your clavicle is. You're going to put weight down in. I'm angling it towards my C7, okay? And it almost feels like if you were choking on a pill or if you had something stuck in your throat. You're applying the pressure for sensation. Don't choke yourself, but apply for sensation. And then you're going to use the breath. You're going to breathe in to that finger in a way that cones the breath back to the cervical spine. And then we're going to release. We're trying to create sensation to teach the tissues how to move to exaggerate that sensation. Okay? Push into the throat. Drive and draw your fingers back. Open up the vertebra right at the C7. It's almost like your fingers are being invited in. And what that ends up doing, instead of pushing your chin back, which locks the gateway from the vagus nerve up into the obligata, down through the cervical spine, it actually opens this ridge. And so we're gonna do two more. Are you ready? Push into the throat. I draw, I'm gonna do it from the side so you can see it. I draw back. Open this ridge. You can even kind of touch it with your finger. And then exhale and release. Last two times. Push in. Draw your fingers back using your breath like a straw on that milkshake. And release. One more time. Push. Draw. And release. Last thing, take your thumbs and just rub on the base of the occipital lobe. First the skin. And then toggle the skull. First the skin, toggle the skull. Inhale, shrug up, and exhale, release. That's it for now. We really want to make sure that your tissue is healthy in three-dimensional space where all of your wiring, all of your glands, all of your systems float. The less stress comes from hydration, mobility, motility, and having fascia in that right consistency so you can be in the right state of mind. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you're interested in learning more, click the subscribe button below and leave a comment, ask a question. I really want to connect with you and continue the conversation about how GST and fascia is revolutionizing body care, health, and wellness.